So we were proving the following theorem. So last time theorem was this: the maximum kameraya bir tarafa bakıyor. The maximum principle so what's that? We had a rectangle where x is ranging between 0 and L. L is a positive number and T is between 0 and T. A closed region. Closed region. So it's a rectangle. Let u x t be a solution of the heat equation, namely u t minus alpha squared u x x equals f x t. Last week we defined, I mean we derived the equation, heat equation, right? Which is continuous. Which is continuous on R. So U is the solution of the heat equation and it is continuous on this rectangle. Then the conclusion is this: if F is negative in R on this region, then u x t attains its maximum values on the boundaries, but not all the I mean whole boundaries. On t equals 0, x is 0, or x equals L, and not in the interior of the region or at t equals big T. Bu sefer eğer if f is positive in R, then the same conclusion, but this time we replace maximum with minimum. Okay. Then uxt attains its minimum values on t equals 0 or x equals L, not in the interior or at t equals t. Yani aynı conclusion. Ama bunu şeye çevirsek, pozitif yaparsak maksimum yerde minimum. Şimdi ispatı tekrar hatırlatayım. Bir kısmını yapmıştık. Proof. Sadece şey yapalım. Let's prove. Prove. Only the part where f is negative. Yani so I'll prove the statement about the maximum. Maximum cannot occur at an interior point or so we have this object. This is the, let's say, t direction. This is the x direction. So this is 0 L and this is 0 T. So we have to, çok yaşa, we have to show that maximum cannot occur inside or here, okay? So maximum should occur somewhere here or here or here, okay? It cannot be at an interior point or at a point where T is big T. Why is that? I mean, there is a, of course, very good reason for that. You see, this is negative. We assume this is negative. This is basically the external heat source. So you are taking heat from the system. Therefore, you expect the temperature decrease in time. So as the temperature decreases, you know, you cannot have maximum here because then it should be, you know, if it is maximum here, then it should be something lower at a point like this. But, you know, it should decrease in time. Therefore, maximum should be either here or at this point. Okay, now the mathematical proof was this, was the following. So case one, we have cases. Okay, so we assume F is negative. I assume that. Okay, now since U is continuous and R is compact, closed and bounded. Compact. Tabii closed and bounded her zaman compact değil. Yani R'de olduğumuz için, değil mi? Gidip öyle söylemeyin. Hoca böyle dedi diye. Okay. RUXT has a maximum at some point. Say x zero t zero. Okay. Now if x0 t0 is an interior point, then by the second derivative test, by the second derivative test, uxx x0 t0 should be negative, because the, I mean, if this is not true, then this should be positive. It means the second derivative is positive, therefore the first derivative is increasing. If the first derivative is increasing, then the function, right? If the first derivative is decreasing and you have a critical point, then this point cannot be maximum. It should be minimum. Okay. So we should have this. And of course, u sub t x zero t zero should be zero, because if we have a critical, I mean, if we have a maximum at an interior point, then it should be a critical point. This should be zero. And also, of course, u sub x, this is also zero. But in particular, this is zero. And this is negative. And if you look at this equation, but then u sub t x zero t zero minus alpha squared u sub x x x zero t zero is equal to f of x zero t zero. I know that this is negative. This is zero, but ha, bu küçük eşit sıfırdı. Bir dakika. Şimdi biz contradiction istiyoruz. Ha, şurası ha. Burası büyük eşit sıfır oldu. Ama sıfır küçük burada a contradiction. Ha, kim bir şey soruyordu? UXX. Yani sıfır da olamıyor tabii o durumda. Yani bu negatifse o zaman bu sıfır da olamıyor. Onu da görmüş oluruz. Tamam. Contradiction niye çıktı? We assume that if this is an interior point, then we have a contradiction. Hence, x0, t0 cannot be an interior point. Bir de diğerine bakacağız. Yok, buna gerek yok. Okay, now if p equals t zero equals t, so in other words, if the point where the maximum is this point x zero p zero is like this, then u sub t x0 t0 should be positive. Why is that? Because otherwise, yani interior nokta olmadığı için, interior nokta olmadığı için, since it is not an interior point, I cannot just say that, this derivative is zero. The maximum may not be occur at an critical point, right? So this derivative doesn't have to be zero. But we claim that it should be non-negative. Why is that? Because otherwise, this would be negative. If it is not positive, then it is negative. But this means what? This means that the t derivative of the temperature is strictly negative. Therefore, it is decreasing, right? Well, at this point, it is decreasing. Therefore, strictly decreasing. Therefore, if you go a little bit below, here temperature should be bigger. Okay? And hence, at nearby points, the temperature would be larger than UX0, T0, right? Because, you know, along this line segment, since it is negative here, it should be negative in an open set like this. Therefore, on this line segment, this function is negative. Therefore, u is a decreasing function of t. Well, since it is decreasing, as t increases, the temperature should drop. Therefore, at a point like this, temperature should be larger than the temperature at this point. Değil mi? Kesinlikle azalan olduğu için. Bu da ne demek? Which is again a contradiction. Okay. So this finishes the proof. Çünkü bunun maksimum olduğunu kabul ettik. Ama şu noktalarda daha da yüksek. Tamam mı? Okay. This finishes the proof for the F is negative case. Tamam. Evet. Tamam. İspat bitmedi. Okay, this shows that okay, the proof didn't finish. So which is a contradiction. Hence ne var? Bu olamaz. Right, so this cannot be true. Therefore we have this. Okay. Şimdi tekrar denkleme bakalım. What was our equation? Our equation was now consider the equation below. So u sub t x zero p zero minus alpha squared u sub x zero equals f x zero y zero. I know that this is negative. This is negative. We know that this is positive. İkincisi için yani eğer bu varsa Bu ne gerektir? This implies that u sub x x x0 y0 is pozitif. Değil mi? Bu pozitif olmalı ki burası negatif olsun. Bu da if this was negative then this would be positive. Another positive. So that would be a contradiction. So this should be strictly positive. But if this is positive, this means what? U sub x, right, is strictly increasing. U sub x increasing say so let's look at again Şöyle, okay. So I am at this point. And all right. U sub x is strictly increasing. So as I move on this axis, this point is an interior point. Right, this is an interior point, and I have so along this line segment, this is a maximum point. Therefore, the first derivative of this x0 t0 is zero, right? This point is not an interior point of this rectangle, but it's an interior point of this line segment, okay? And my function restricted to this line segment is a function of one variable, x only, t is constant, and it has a maximum here. Therefore, the first derivative at this point should be zero. And I know that second derivative is positive. It means that so second derivative test ne der o zaman? Bu line segment için ikinci türev pozitif. Burada da şey ise o zaman ikinci yani şurada kritik noktası bu increasing olduğuna göre yani şurada o zaman bir dakika. Yani şöyle olması lazım. Increasing olduğuna göre. Şöyle o zaman değil mi? First derivative is increasing. Therefore it should have a minimum at this point. So at a point like this, so it should have a minimum here as x increases. So it should be larger here. And then it should smaller here. So this point cannot be a maximum. Okay? It is increasing. Pardon, pardon. Bir dakika. Şeyden sıfıra eşit dedim. Şöyle. Şimdi bu fonksiyonun bütün rectangle'da maksimumu bu ya. Dolayısıyla şurada da maksimumu bu. So on this line segment it has a maximum here. This is one dimensional object and this is a function of x only. T is constant. And it has a maximum at an interior point. Therefore, the derivative of this function respect to x at this point should be zero. The derivative of u with respect to x at this point is this gadget. Bu sıfır. Şu türev sıfır. O zaman bu noktada da bunun maksimumu değil, minimumu var. Değil mi? So here, since this is positive, so ux 0, t 0 is not a maximum on the line segment t equals t. Yani şu doğru boyunca şu noktada bunun şu nokta u fonksiyonun maksimumu değil, bilakis bir tane local minimumu. O da contradiction. Right. This is again a contradiction. Contradiction niye çıktı? We assume that it is a maximum on that line segment. Hence the maximum point x0 t0 cannot be on the line t equals t. O zaman ne kaldı? Ya içeride ya da diğer üç köşeden birin, pardon, içeride de yok. On neydi? Ya x eşittir 0 ya x eşittir l or p equals 0. Yani şu üçünden birinde. Tamam mı? the case f is positive is similar. Aslında onu ispat etmeye bile gerek yok muhtemelen. Çünkü well, actually you don't even have to prove this case. Why is that? Because if you replace u with if you replace u function u with minus u, then minimum of this becomes maximum of this, and if you plug minus u here, then you will get minus f here. Therefore f is positive turns to the case f is negative, and we have proved that. Değil mi? Yani f'in pozitif olduğu durumda her şeyi eksi 1 ile çarparsanız u yerine eksi u alacaksınız. So for the case f is positive, just multiply this equation by minus 1. That will replace u with minus u. And we proved that in case this is negative, the solution cannot have a maximum. But since I replaced u with minus u, it means u cannot have a minimum. Okay, so this case is, you know, that comes for free. Huh. Evet, şunu gösterdik. Yani maksimum varsa U fonksiyonu maksimum var tabii ki. Kompakt bir küme üzerinde kontinüs. O maksimum point içeride olamaz ya da şurada olamaz. Tabii şurada olabilir. Onu şey yapmıyoruz ama bu zaten bizim statement'ımıza da aykırı değil. Biz ne diyoruz? Şu üç köşeden birinde olacak. Yani region'ın içinde olmayacak ya da şu kenarın içinde olmayacak. Şurada mı? Burada olabilir. Buralarda olabiliyor. Burada, burada onu ispat ettik. İçeride olmayacak. Burada olmayacak, bir de burada olmayacak. Burada olabilir. T eşittir sıfır burası. Neresi? Şurası mı? İşte şey dedik ya, izon burada, burada veya burada. Yani evet, bunlar or. Is on, şuraya or. Or. Tamam mı? Okey. All right. We have another theorem. Okay. Let u xt, ha, bunun da adı maximum principle. Diğerinin de adı maximum principle değil miydi? Evet. Bu ama homojen denklem. So this is the maximum principle. Let u xt be a solution of this equation u sub t minus no u sub t is equal to alpha squared u x x or this equation. Okay, so f is zero where x is between zero and L and t is between zero and t which is continuous. On R. R is this region. Olsun. Then the zaman bitti mi? Maximum and minimum values of UXT are on the line t equals zero or x equals zero or x equals L. So the same conclusion, okay? But this time we have homogeneous equation f is zero. Bakalım bunun ispatı nasıl? Proof. Let us introduce an auxiliary function. VXT, which is just UXT, the original solution plus epsilon times x squared, where epsilon is a positive constant. Then of course the XT is still continuous on R because U was continuous. I added something like this. It is still continuous, and hence has a maximum. It has a maximum at some point. Point x1 t1 in R. Okay. Assume that x1 t1 is an interior point. Of R. Yani şunu kabul edelim. X1 0 ile L arasında, T1 da 0 ile T arasında. Bunu kabul edelim. Okay, since this function has a maximum at an interior point, right? We should have from the first derivative test, then we must have V sub T x1 T1 is positive and V sub xx x1 T1 is negatif. Değil mi? İçeride bir interior point'iniz varsa, pardon, maksimum interior'daysa, so from the first derivative test, aslında bunun sıfır olması lazım. Niye böyle almış ki? This should be zero. Efendim? Bu niye negatif? Çünkü pozitif olsaydı o zaman minimum olurdu, maksimum olmazdı. Şimdi V sub t minus alpha squared V sub xx. What is this? V sub t. So when you take t derivative of this, you get t derivative of this, and this just vanishes. So you just have u sub t minus alpha squared v sub xx. If I take x derivative of this, I get x derivative of this, and here we get 2 epsilon x. And if I take second derivative, then this epsilon goes also. So I get u sub xx plus 2 epsilon. But we know that u sub t minus alpha squared u sub xx and minus alpha, okay, 2 epsilon alpha squared. I know that this is zero because u is the solution of the heat equation, right? From the statement of the theorem. So we get minus 2 epsilon alpha squared, which is negative. But here, this is at this point, this is zero, and this is negative, another negative. So this thing is non-negative, but here it is negative. So this is a contradiction. So if it is an interior point, then we obtain a contradiction. Ama işte o F negatif olduğu için. Aslında evet. Hiç bunu yapmaya gerek yok. Evet, haklısın. Okay, now indeed, şöyle yazayım. Indeed, since yani daha şunu so this is just a solution of this equation. So I just consider this as my f. It's a constant function and it is negative. By the previous theorem, cannot have a maximum at an interior point. Point or on the line or on the line t equals t. Evet. V için bunu söylüyoruz. U için ne diyeceğiz? Nerede? Ya aslında via this line actually I don't need this argument. Right? Okay. We just make this computation and we see that v is a continuous function and it's a solution of this equation where f is a constant function and it is negative. So by the previous theorem, we cannot have a maximum at an interior point or on the segment t equals t. Tamam mı? Yani o argümanları tekrar yapmaya gerek yok. Ama bizim derdimiz tabii we are trying to prove that you cannot have a maximum and here we obtain that conclusion for we. So how can we translate this to you? Aha. Ama V'nin maksimum olduğu yerde U'nun olduğunu biliyor muyuz? Yani o şimdi bu noktada V'nin maksimumu var ya. Öyle kabul ettik. O çok haklı olabilirsin de yani emin olamadım. Şöyle şimdi devam ediyoruz. Let M be the maximum of UXT on t equals 0, x equals 0 and x equals l. So I have this three line segments and m is the maximum of u on this union of three line segments. Then we have this VXT is UXT plus epsilon times x squared and this is less than m. Write u is less than m and plus epsilon times l squared because x is between x is between 0 and l right x is somewhere here and this is 0 this is l. So x value is always between 0 and L. Therefore, this expression is less than this gadget for why is that? Because we know that the maximum of this function is somewhere here, or here, or here. And on this three line segments, this function, which is equal to this gadget, and it is less than this. Therefore, v is less than this expression on the whole rectangle. Okay? Peki, yani şey çünkü V'nin maksimumunun zaten şurada bir yerde olduğunu biliyorum. Bu üçünün üzerinde de bu ifade buna eşit ama bu M'den küçüktü. Bu da işte bu sayıdan küçük. Yani şunun üzerinde bu nesne bundan küçük. Ama içeride zaten maksimumdan küçük. Maksimum da buradaki noktalardan biri. Ama buradaki noktalardaki değeri de zaten bundan küçük. Tamam mı? O halde V değeri bütün dikdörtgende bundan küçük. Şimdi buradan sonra ne yapacağız? Şöyle. Since V XD has its maximum on t equals 0, x equals 0 or x equals l O zamanı geçirmişiz. Neyse 2 dakika daha şey yapayım. Bitiriyorum. We obtain UXT which is VXT Since I am subtracting something positive, I have this. And this is less than m plus epsilon l squared. So, UXT is less than this gadget. Yes. This is true, of course, for all XT, right? Çünkü for all XT, I have this. Yani bu, şunlar birbirine eşit zaten. O da bundan küçük. Ama bunun maksimum değeri zaten şundan küçüktü. O halde rectangle'ın içinde bu ifade bundan küçük. Ama burada şunu görüyoruz. Here epsilon is arbitrary, right? Since epsilon is arbitrary, we see that UXT is less than M for all XT in R. But what was M? M was the maximum of u on this three line segments. M was the maximum of u here. Therefore, the maximum of u should occur somewhere here. If it was here, then I mean if u had a value here which is larger than this one, then I cannot have this. Tamam mı? Hence the maximum of u is attained on a point at a point on x equals 0, x equals l or t equals 0. So this finishes the proof. Okay. So let's have a break. 10 minutes break.